She did it! The audience cheered loudly. But it wasn't always like that. The Kudos have been through many difficult times. Their goalie, Mackenzie Arnold, has had hearing loss since she was a child. She inspires many people who have disabilities who want to play soccer too. And despite her disability, she has saved 42 goals in the recent World Cup. Don't you think the Matildas have done well this World Cup? They have worked hard to get to it. They trained in Melbourne by their coach Tony Gustafson, and they were led by their captain Sam Kerr. Not forgetting their massive semi-final match against the Rhinoceros. The Lionesses, and Sam Kerr's won the goal. Sam Kerr started playing soccer when she was 12 years old. Her first team was the Western Knights. She played with them from 2006 to 2008 and has continued to go to other teams, but she has been an amazing Matildas player. The Matildas encourage young children between the age of 10 and 12 to play soccer. Many people have played and watched soccer because of the Matildas. They are an inspiration to everyone, and the community continues to support them. Over 11 million Australians watch the Matildas. When you feel like you're bored or don't know what to do, you could try watching the Matildas, or even playing soccer. Who knows? You might be a famous soccer player. There are a lot of soccer players in the Matildas, but players like Mary Fowler stood out. Mary Fowler has been a well-known player. She played in 2 World Cups. Her dream was to be in the Olympics. Played in the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. She completed that dream. Mary Fowler is proud to be part of the Matildas. Another amazing player is Hayley Rasso. She had an injury in 2018. She broke her back in a collision with another player, but she healed after 6 months. Hayley Rasso often wears a ribbon in her hair. She wore a ribbon in her hair since she was a child. Her grandma makes the ribbons for her. Do you know why she wears a ribbon? So her grandma can spot her in the field. Overall, she's an outstanding player. Altogether, they make a great team. Sam Kerr once said, always believe in yourself and always be proud of who you are.
Congratulations to our nearby finalists. Nia. Cressida. Isabel.
I wanted to just go over what we look at as adjudicators, because sometimes you think, oh, that person didn't win, I thought they were going to win, but there's actually a lot involved. So we obviously look at how prepared they are, and if they've got palm cards, and if they did their homework and practiced. We also look for their voice. And today, up the back, it was really hard to hear some of the content because their voice didn't project. So that's a skill that you have to learn. We also look for how expressive and fluent and how their diction comes out. You can hear them emphasizing words. And if they looked around at the audience, if they looked at the camera, or if they were looking at their notes like this, we look at our bodies. How we stand, if they use gestures, and we look at content. And if it was like a topical topic, or if it was an interesting topic, if they had a little bit of humour in there, that sort of thing. And we also look for timing. Sometimes if you go too short or too long, you get points off. So it's quite complex. All right, you ready to hear the results?
Yeah.
Okay. As we said, we were very, very impressed by what we heard, and it was really quite close. Okay, our runner-ups for year five, and it was very, very close to year five, was Nia. Nia was lovely and expressive, easy to listen to. We all learned about failure, learning from our mistakes, and to bounce back.